Blackstone presents The Sanctuary by Andrew Hunter Murray. This book is read by Andrew Hunter Murray.
The Sanctuary, written and read by Andrew Hunter Murray. Prologue. He has heard for years that this day would come. He always dutifully believed it, repeated the words with the rest of the congregation, but he didn't seriously imagine it, nor that he would feel such strange pleasure when it did. He doesn't have a gun. He's only 14 and slight. His mother has explained that the recoil alone would knock him flat. He was always told there was no need to rush his training. Except now, with the firing outside, and the sand-colored armored vehicles crawling forward, the cowardly troops shielded by them pressing ever closer. Now he wishes he had one. Still, he has the next best thing. He's been down to the kitchens. A knife won't be missed now, not in the middle of all this. The older men and women are running through the corridors, finding the best positions to return fire, but he has his own labor to fulfill. He walks calmly, with it balanced in his hand. Back upstairs, he sees the great man. He's standing behind a column, holding a rifle and glancing outwards, coordinating, shouting. He is alone. There is something about him that is always curiously alone. If he ran the place, the boy thinks, he doubts whether he would make all the same decisions the great man did. He is not sure, if he was the great man, whether he would hit others so enthusiastically, nor for so long. Although these thoughts are heresy, of course, and the great man is simply acting on instructions from the highest power of all. The gunfire is much closer now. It has made the day hotter. The individual bullets have warmed the air, agitating it like wasps as they slap the walls. The men approaching the compound are gaining, but the battle is in the balance. Beyond the outer wall, something explodes. When you are small and weak, a knife simply requires a sharp point. His mother has shown him this in the kitchens, how a little pressure exerted in the right place can create a great rip in an animal's side. All you need, she has explained, is the courage to create the first incision, and the rest will follow on. It's a lesson he likes far more than any the great man has taught him over the years. She has explained, too, how to recognize a moment of opportunity. The great man is distracted, facing away and glancing out of the window. He laughs as one of the uniformed men outside falls and bellows to his own followers that they are winning. It is so little effort, just a few steps, to cross the room towards him, find the right point in his side, free of ribs, just like on a pig, and with a quick gesture, to bury the blade. One, two, three. The great man looks down and drops his gun. He stumbles into the window's light and is immediately cut down by bullets from without. His eyes rest on the boy, but they're glazing already, and the boy cannot tell whether the great man sees who did this to him. He hopes he does. The gunfire from within the compound crackles on, but without the dominant note of its leader, it will not last long. The boy pauses only to wipe a rough cloth over the knife's handle, removing the fingerprints, then leaves the body and returns downstairs. He walks calmly once again. His mother will be proud. Book 1. Mainland. Straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. The Book of Matthew, chapter 7. Verse 14. Chapter 1. The week I travelled to Pemberley's Island was the week the old king and the last elephant had both died. And although any connection between the two deaths seemed too glib to make, for several days one was hardly mentioned without the other. Two exemplars of their respective species, two mighty symbols of venerability and distinction, that sort of thing. You could write it yourself in 5 minutes, if you were fool enough or had news to sell. They died days apart, the elephant went first. Accounts of them drawing their last breath at the same moment were later revealed to be nothing but sensational fabrications, the fevered work of journalists who should have taken up fiction instead. Although looking at what followed, perhaps the double extinction was significant after all. Once the king went, the eradication...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.